the joy you'll find when you leave the world behind
and bid your cares goodbye.
Hi everyone, this is Thomas Kincaid. My new painting, Tinker Bell and Peter Pan Fly to Neverland, is very important to me because it's a reminder of some of my most precious daydreams as a young boy. Peter Pan represented for me a wonderful flight of the imagination, not just because the characters visit Neverland, but also because of the wonderful views of London. The scene of the characters taking flight out of the window and soaring high above London has to be one of the great cinematic moments ever. As I began work on the Peter Pan composition, I was torn because there is the world of Neverland, where many of the adventures of the film happen, and then there's the world of London. This presented a dilemma because clearly there is not a scene from the movie that would capture all the elements I wanted to paint. As I began work, I once again sought to develop a composition that encompasses what I call the narrative panorama of the movie. In other words, when you see a painting depicting a Disney movie, oftentimes you see a scene from the movie, an individual setting that was encompassed by the plot of the movie. In my case, I wanted to tell the whole story of the movie through a single image. This narrative panorama technique allows me to be very creative and invent new ways to tell the story. In the case of my painting, Tinker Bell and Peter Pan Fly to Neverland, I created the device of the clouds, which are taking shape as the central characters of the story. The wonderful thing about the clouds as an element to depict the characters is that we're never quite sure if these clouds are taking shape in real life or only in our imagination. I enjoyed painting the character of the Indian chief, Mr. Smee, Captain Hook with his leering expression, the lost boys who gather around the left-hand side of the composition, and of course the ticking crocodile, which figures so prominently in the story. We see the crocodile emerging from the clouds as though he is emerging from water, perhaps the waters of the Thames River below. In addition to the characters in the clouds, we see the mystic galleon, the sailing ship that transports the children back to the real world of London. If you recall the final scene in the movie, the galleon ship that the children have return to London upon begins to disperse and becomes a cloud. It's a wonderful transition device because we as the viewer of the movie are left wondering if the entire adventure in Neverland was real or perhaps just a daydream from the children. The story of Peter Pan begins in London. We learn that Wendy, the young girl who is one of the central characters of the story, has been asked to move out of the nursery, and this will be her final night, so to speak, as a child. But just before she and the other children go to bed, Peter Pan arrives on the windowsill and convinces the children to join him on a wondrous adventure to Neverland, a land where children don't have to grow up. To transport the children, Tinkerbell provides pixie dust, which allows you to fly if only you can think good thoughts. This sets the stage for the thrilling flight above London as the children learn to use their newfound powers to fly high above the city below. As Peter Pan leads the children beyond the cloudy landscape of London, he sets his sights on the second star to the right. In my painting, we see the second star to the right, the guiding landmark that leads us to Neverland. In the Peter Pan movie, the children circle Neverland and look down upon the adventures that await them. To the left, we see the Indian encampment, scene of many adventures as the children meet with the great chief. In the center of Neverland, we see the captain's ship. Captain Hook and his men are the enemies of Peter Pan and would find ways to trap the children if they could. To the right of the pirate ship, we see the hideout of the Lost Boys. James Barry, the wonderful author who created Peter Pan, envisioned the Lost Boys as children without a home. And in the Disney movie, the Lost Boys are transformed into a rough and tumble group of young boys who are always up for any adventure. In a cove to the far right of the island, we see Mermaid Lagoon. And if you look carefully enough, you can see some mermaids cavorting on the rocks. Skull Rock is at the far right of the composition. And of course, this is the setting where Captain Hook transports Princess Tiger Lily, the daughter of the big Indian chief. I enjoyed the fact that there are several different lighting sources in this painting. On the one hand, we have the rising sun, which is in the distance beyond the island of Neverland. This casts a lot of warm light, including pinks and ochre tones and orangey, pale, rosy tones. To the right is a full moon, which casts a pale, greenish light that illuminates the characters that we see in the clouds. Of course, Tinker Bell and Big Ben behind her create their own amber light, which causes a radiant glow in the lower right-hand corner of the painting. Of course, what would a Thomas Kinkade painting be without hidden elements? And my painting, Tinker Bell and Peter Pan Fly to Neverland, is no exception. Spanning the Thames River below them is the Tower Bridge, a famous landmark in London. If you look upon the bridge, you will see vintage vehicles that suggest an earlier day in London. Of course, the Peter Pan movie does not depict vehicles in London, but if you recall the wonderful ride in Disneyland, you will see London below you. And the Imagineers of Disney Studios created a sense of moving lights, suggesting that small vehicles were crossing the bridge. In all my Disney paintings, I hide tributes to the Disney organization, including the famous Hidden Mickeys. There are many Hidden Mickeys in this painting. An example is Big Ben. Just below the clock to the left, you'll see a Mickey, three little dots of light. It's a reminder that, as Walt Disney said, it all started with a mouse. To the lower left of the composition, we see another Hidden Mickey, a balloon vendor, and of course, he's sporting an entire group of Mickey Mouse balloons. In the story, Nana the dog gets sprinkled with pixie dust and is seen flying high above London as her rope tethers her to the ground. Vintage boats are making their way up the Thames, and of course the lights of London sparkle and reflect in the waters. The cityscape was fascinating and allowed the opportunity for lots of hidden details. See if you can allow your eye to wander through the neighborhoods of London and discover the beautiful architecture that characterizes this historic city. Looking over the scene in the lower right foreground in front of the bridge is Snow White and Pinocchio. In my Disney paintings, I hide tributes whenever I can to other characters from Disney movies. I thought it was appropriate, as I created painting number 3 in the series, to create a tribute to the other 2 paintings I've done so far. There are 25 hidden ends in the painting, a tribute to my wife Nanette, and a tribute to my 25th year as a published artist. The theme of Peter Pan is the tug of war that exists between a child's desire to cling to the fantasies and the joys of youth, and the ultimate necessity to grow up. There's a very special energy in the story of Peter Pan that captivated me as a child. I must say it's been a tremendous honor to work on this tribute painting to Tinker Bell and Peter Pan. I hope I've captured some of the energy of the story, and that this painting will be a reminder to many millions of people to never lose sight of your childhood dreams. This is Thomas Kinkade reminding you to keep sight of the second star to the right as we sail straight on till morning in search of Neverland. God bless.
There it is, Wendy. Second star to the right and straight on till morning.
You can fly, you can fly, you can fly, you can fly, you can fly.